First, before I start talking about anything, I would like to talk about the setting that I consider. And we start off with, you know, this guy up there on the right. So first, let us talk about terminology. So my interpretation of the current state of the art or state of affairs in AI is that deep learning is a part of machine learning, and machine learning in turn is a part of AI. This is quite frequently confused. And, you know, this is one of these Venn diagrams. And of course, you might argue how much space is there, how many elements are there in between. But it's definitely not one and the same, you know, machine learning, deep learning, machine learning and AI. There have been many, many successful combinations and integrations of various methods there. So let's move it up there. So what I consider in many real world scenarios is that there's a machine learning component. It usually interacts with some other component like problem solving or reasoning. This is again embedded or included, integrated into some other software system. And of course, this has to be optimized and running on some hardware. And not only that, it has to interact with humans. And then there's a whole ecosystem of such systems, technical systems, and interacting with each other, all possibly with an intelligent and learning component. So I think we all agree that we live in a world that is very complex, very messy, and it's not getting easier to build such systems in a good way, and fulfill all sorts of constraints and you know, desired properties at the same time. So this is the setting that I consider, and I just wanted to make sure in the beginning that we have this common understanding of deep learning, machine learning, and AI. So I made a list. So when I thought about this invited talk, about this keynote, I thought of all these nice lists that have been made. There's one by Pedro Domingos from 4 years ago. It's very nice. 10 myths about machine learning. So I don't want to repeat that. You know, there's a little bit of an intersection here with my list, but it's 10. So then there's a nice paper by Cynthia Rudin, you know, 10 things you wish you had known earlier to be more effective at data analysis, secrets of machine learning. It's also very, very nice, a very nice read.